In the previous tutorials, I showed you how to create a new podcast, a new show, and then how to upload a new episode to that podcast. Next, I want to show you analytics. Now, when you first start out, your analytics are not that interesting. There's just not enough data here. And really, you'll probably need a month or two to start collecting analytics and stats that are interesting. So what I'm going to do is show you an existing show that already has quite a few analytics there, so I can walk you through the different categories. Over here on the left side of your analytics screen, we'll show you average downloads per episode. So in the first 7 days after publishing an episode, how many downloads or listens do I get for that episode? So our average is 2,310 in the first 7 days. In the first 30 days, it's 2,800, just over that. And then in the first 90 days, almost 3,300. Often when you're selling ads, the advertisers want to see this information. On average, how many downloads or listens does your podcast episodes get in the first 7, 30, 60, or 90 days? So that's your average there. Over here on the right, we estimate how many subscribers your podcast has. Now, because podcasting is this open distributed protocol, nobody owns the distribution for podcasting. It's shared by Apple and Spotify and Google and all the players. We have to guess how many people are subscribed to your show. And the way we do that is we average out the first 24 hours of downloads for your last three episodes. And so then we're just estimating how many subscribers we think you have based on that number. So for our show, it's about 1,300. We think about 1,300 people are actually subscribed to the show or follow the show on Apple Podcasts or Spotify, and they're getting the episode right away as soon as it drops. Down below that, we have this listener trends graph. And right now I have it showing listens from all time. You can hover over and see the monthly downloads we've gotten for each of these months. We can have this show a graph for today. So at 6 a.m., we had 46 downloads. I could have it show yesterday. Here's the downloads we got throughout the day. I can have it show for this year, last year, and the past 365 days, past 90 days, or a custom date range. So this is a really customizable chart, and you can slice and dice it however you'd like. Even more powerful, you can export all of this data as a CSV file. So if I wanted to see all of the data from last year, I can download that as a CSV file, and then I can open that in Excel or Numbers or Google Sheets. Down below that graph, we have episode breakdowns. And right now it's set to show me downloads per episode for the first 30 days since publishing. And that's showing right here. So in the first 30 days, this episode had almost 2,000 downloads. This episode here had almost 2,400. And this gives you a sense of how popular a given episode is in its first 30 days. But you can show first 30 days, first 14 days, today, how many downloads did each episode get today? How many downloads did each episode get yesterday? And then all of the same filters plus a custom range. So if I wanted to see how many downloads each episode got in the past year, I can filter by that. And again, I can export this as a CSV file, open that up in Excel or Numbers or Google Sheets, and then I get a daily tally of downloads per episode for the last 365 days. If you want to really get in there and make your own charts or your own reports, that export to CSV functionality is really powerful. Next up, we have podcast players. This is often the graph that people are really interested in because you'll want to know where are people listening to your podcast. For example, if a lot of your listeners are in Overcast, like we have, you can actually have ads on Overcast to promote your show, and you might want to do that to get more listeners. You can filter this graph by Xing out any of the players you don't want to see. So if I just wanted to see Overcast in here, I could take all these out. If I just wanted to see Overcast and Spotify and Apple Podcasts, I can do it that way. And it'll give you a sense of, yeah, where your listeners are listening, what apps they use to listen to your show. This is also exportable as a CSV file, and you can also filter it by all these options. So if I wanted to see, you know, what people use to listen to my podcast in the last 90 days, I could filter it that way. Down below that, we give you an overview of what devices people are using. Not surprising, most people are listening on their phone. Desktop browsers next. Desktop application, like, you know, the desktop version of Apple Podcasts is after that. A mobile web browser. Other. Smartwatch is about 2% of our show. And over here, we'll show you are people on iOS, Android, macOS, Windows, etc. And then finally, we have this great map of where your listeners are located. So for us, most of our downloads come from Canada and the US, but I can see how many downloads we got in India, in Australia, in Russia, in France. And this is also exportable as a CSV file. And you can even see down here a breakdown by country. And whenever it's possible, we'll break it down by region or state like this. So United Kingdom, Canadian provinces, Australian provinces. Yeah, you get a further breakdown of where your listeners are located within that country. And that's how podcast analytics look on Transistor.